feeling so small. Watch the clock ticking off the wall. But tonight I'm letting it go. Spend my coin for sure. I'm gonna be myself, or it could be someone else. No one's stopping me now. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I just wanna feel alive. It's just what I do when I'm out, so try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look up at those beautiful stars. I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me, no, no, nothing can break me. Try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look up at those beautiful stars. I wanna take a trip to Mars. Nothing can break me, no, no, nothing can break me. Drive a faster car. I'm gonna be myself, I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna be myself, I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna be myself, I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna be myself, I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. Try not to hold me down, feel alive when I'm in this town. Look at those beautiful stars. I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me. No, no, nothing can break me. Try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look at those beautiful stars. I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me. No, no, nothing can break me. Nothing can break me, no, no, nothing can break me.
And they go into the forest and they come back and they do that. But you can get upgrades, which is the best thing, because you have to basically manage your babies. Paco, Charles, Susie, and Orangey. Yeah, that's right. So I almost forgot the name. You have to manage them correctly in order to get like the most efficient like food return going there. And as you can see, you can add more babies, and oh, I have to think of another name. Paco, Charles, Susie, and let's call you Devin. How about that? Paco, Charles, Susie, and Devin. You guys go get the food for Princess Nom Nom or Princess Mom Mom, whatever you want to call her. I guess you guys would call her Princess Mom Mom. I would call her Princess Nom Nom. And, all right. There they go. Paco, Charles, Susie, Orangey. Wait, Orangey. Ooh, Paco, Charles, Susie. Oh my gosh, I'm losing track of their names. Okay, so the upgrades, what they do is you could make it so your little guys run faster. Your Paco, Charles, Susie, Orangey, and Devin. Yeah, I got them all right. I got them all right. They just keep going and they just keep going and they bring back more food so you can have more little tiny babies. Look, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, we just had three. Why did I do that? I can control this too. Okay, all right. Paco, Charles, Susie, Orangey, and Devin, and I didn't think this far ahead, did I? I just kept naming them. I'm gonna call the other guy. You know, I'm gonna call the other guy. I'm gonna call you Rocks, because that's all I can think of right now. Paco, Charles, Susie, Rocks, Grass, and Dirt. I'm just talking about what I see. All right, so. All right, upgrade some of the food looted from the forest. Let's do that. All right, so that way I can have more food, and so we can have more babies, so we can get more return for what we're doing. So, there we go. All right, so we got Paco, Charles, Susie, Orangey, Devin, Dirt, Rocks, and I guess Trees is one of your names now too. I really should be writing this down. I should know all of my children's little names, but I can't because we keep having them at an alarming rate. Okay, all right. So now we have 10 babies, which is the max amount of babies you can have running into the forest, bringing back their mom food. I don't know where they're getting these grapes from. There must be like a grape vine there, because I don't think grapes come from trees. They don't come from trees, actually. I know they don't. I don't know why I said that. I just can't think because now it's moving a little bit faster. All right, so we have so much food right now, and we haven't even upgraded to the other places you can go. So you can have a fishing pond, and the fishing pond, what you can do is, of course, you can have another baby, and you can assign the baby to go get some fish. There you go, go get the fish. You can also have a wheat farm. Okay, all right. So I haven't gotten this far in the game, so some of these things are just a little new to me, so I'm just kind of getting used to it. But yeah, so you can have another little baby. You can have the baby go to the wheat farm. You can have the other ones go to the to get the more of the grapes. And this one goes to get the fish, and that one got a steak from a wheat farm. Okay, all right, cool. I'm not gonna question. Your name's gonna be called Juicy because you bring back really great steaks, apparently. Okay. Where are they getting the steaks from? Are they slaughtering like little, are my babies like little murder machines slaughtering cows or something? I mean, kudos to them. I just never raised them to, you know, whatever. Okay, they want to be farmers, that's fine. They can be little farmers. All right, so we're having more babies still. Let's see what our upgrade options are. We can have more fishing. Let's do that. Let's upgrade our fishing. Let's just keep upgrading things as we go. That way, it's just the best thing ever. Look at the babies go. All right, so there we go. Oh, they brought a sushi. Oh, we got a sushi chef in the family. This is great. I mean, for them, it's great. For real me, it's not. But for Princess Nom Nom, or whatever they call her, like, whatever our baby, I feel like they would call her Princess Mom Mom. I just think that's adorable, because if her actual royal name is Princess Nom Nom, then it would be Princess Mom Mom for them, because that's their nickname. That's what I would think, at least. Okay, so we got a lot of babies, we got a lot of stuff going on. Let's see what our upgrade options are. Reduce all, okay, so we got some nice exploration options. Look at that, and we have more babies coming, and it just keeps getting faster and faster and faster. I'm reducing time to get stuff, because that way we can have more things going on, and there's just a lot going on to manage right now. Really trying to commentate and manage all this is crazy. I highly recommend playing this game if you, like, love to just, like, see these adorable things bring back food, because I would love to have these adorable things bring me food all the time. Alright, more babies. Oh, another Susie! Look at you, tiny Susie! You're gonna do great things! You're gonna go get some fish, and then you're gonna go to fish college so you learn how to become a sushi chef. That's not how you become a sushi chef, by the way. I just want to point that out. Yeah, that's not how you become a sushi chef. You become a sushi chef by years of practice, and I actually don't know how you obviously want to start cooking, so you go to the fridge and make some eggs right now. But let's keep going. Just keep going after the steaks and the- Oh, this one's bringing back cupcakes! I just realized that! That's the best thing ever! I want that farm! Is that a farm? Like, there's just a farm where, like, bakers grow out of the ground? And, like, Susie, what are you doing with your life when you have, like, the chef over here, this career? All right, so I got a lot of stuff going on. I can do a lot of upgrades. Let's do this upgrade. Let's do, increase all food gains. Let's do that one, too. We got a lot going on here. And let's have more babies. There we go. Perfect. More babies. I can't name them all. All I know, I have Paco, Orangey, Devin, Susie, look at the crown. Did the crown get bigger? I can't really tell for some reason. I haven't been paying attention to the crown. I've just been eating everything. I feel like I should also click that other thing. Oh my god, oh pastries. Oh my, I am so hungry right now. This game is making me really, really hungry. All right, let's open that one too and send someone over there. Let's send everyone everywhere and just keep having, this is great. All right, origin of all nom. Transcend your non-existence, become the nom itself. I need that. All right, just keep going. Come on, little guys. There's a little apple. Oh, look, we got a healthy option. I mean, not that we didn't have an healthy option with the grapes, but now we have a healthier option with the apples. There we go. All right, so we got apples, we got grapes, we got cupcakes, we got T-bone steak. I'm really hungry now. I'm really hungry. Look at all of them go. All right, give me some more little nom noms. There we go. All right, this one bringing the apples is going really slow. I mean, I feel like, is that a Susie? Oh, that was a Susie. Oh, Susie decided to change what her job was. She wanted to be an apple salesperson or apple maker. You can't really make apples. I guess you can apple farmer. Yeah, I guess that's what you would call it, an apple farmer. All right, there we go. So we got all these little guys coming. Let's see. We got more upgrades. We got all four places going. We got so much food coming in. It's I don't know how Princess Nom Nom's going to handle this. I think she looks a little pinker for some reason. I can't tell. Let's see where this goes. All right, so I keep upgrading the cake farm. I'm sorry, but I prefer cake over fish. It's just a personal preference. But fish is great too. But like, if I had the choice between cake and fish, I would definitely go with cake. All right, there's some of my cake coming in, some apples. I got some nom noms that aren't doing anything, and I guess they just don't have a job. So I gotta give them a job. I gotta upgrade the fish farm and everything. There we go. All right. Maybe I should upgrade the apple place, but I feel like I should finish the cupcake one. It's so hard to figure out what I want to do with all this. Okay, all right. Oh, look, I just finished upgrading. That was really easy. All right, there, and then I got a lot of nom noms coming in. All right, yeah, that was really easy. I should have just upgraded that from the beginning. I didn't realize how easy that was to upgrade. All right, what other upgrades are available? Upgrading that. So much to do. So little time. All right, well, I got lots of time because I am eating like everything. There we go. All right, sending all my little guys out there. I got 40 of them, which I think is enough nom noms to like satisfy. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. I need 50 nom noms actually in order to break even with all the places. There we go. Okay, so here, I'm gonna send one over this way because I feel like whoever's going there is a little lonely. All right, there we go. Sending more noms out. Oh, there's two Susies that went over there. I'm so proud of you, Susie. Wow! That is huge. That is huge. I was not expecting a whole trumpet of food. I was not expecting that. I wonder what else is over there now. I'm kind of really curious. What are they getting over there? All right. All right, more stuff. I don't know if I want to do that yet. I kind of want to upgrade my cupcake farm because I feel like if I'm going to transcend all the... You know what? Let's just transcend. Let's do it. Oh, wait. I don't have the ability to transcend it anymore. I guess I spent my money on something? What did I spend my money on? No, just keep going. Just keep going. All right.
The prophecy is true.
Okay, so my game ended up crashing on me, so I kind of improv the ending just a teeny bit there. Yeah, a bit of an over-exaggeration, but still. Anyway, what the game does is it tells you your time, and it shows you how long it took you to get to that transcend nom buttons, and it's just, and then you could play it again. So the game is really addictive, highly recommend it, and it's just so fun. I already miss my children because I name them, and when you name something, you get really attached to it. So thank you guys for tuning into this video. Be sure to leave a like and a comment, and if you want to play Princess Nom Nom, down in the description below, and I look forward to seeing you all next time. Until then, don't transcend your noms. Bye! Or explode, whichever one comes first. Jess here, and today I want to sit down with you all and have a serious talk. Mano a mano, mi este you. I was never really good at Spanish, but yeah, let's just ignore that. So today I actually want to have a serious conversation about stuff that has been going on in the community, mostly having to deal with a lot of negativity going on in the air and just like some things that I've been long overdue to address. And I feel like right now is the best time to do that. It's a time where like I just got my wisdom tooth taken out, but I have some notes over here, by the way, like pointers. That way I can actually like keep on topic because I have this really bad way of like getting off topic on a vlog. Like right now it's happening. But seriously, I do want to sit down and have a serious one-on-one conversation with you guys about stuff that has been going on in the community. Because recently a lot of people have been upset with me over the fact that I've been ignoring new and old artists in the community when before I was able to actually keep up with a lot of them. And honestly, there's a lot of negativity around the air about that subject, and I just want to get into it and talk about it. Just a heads up, this video has no monetization on it because it's a talk. I want to have this talk with you guys, and it's something that I need to talk about. There's going to be a lot of talks that I want to have in the future, which probably will be monetized because they're things that I do like on my casual time, but this is something that is serious, and I want to be able to talk with you guys about this from heart to heart. So no monetization going on this video. So first off, going back to the original subject of me not being able to support new artists and old artists in my community, you're right. I haven't had a chance to actually just sit down the way that I used to at my computer and do that. It's been very difficult for me ever since I moved. Before, I had the luxury of just sitting down, being able to have my life stable, and then like going on my computer and being able to do things not only for me, but for my community, for my artists. I would love to do that kind of stuff. But ever since I moved, my entire life reset, my kids' life reset. And it's just been insane the amount of work that I've had to do. Granted, it's really hard to show you guys exactly what I do, and I'm gonna try to make a better effort to actually show you guys what kind of work I do behind the scenes. And I can't police like all the art like I used to. I used to be able to find like the OP, do a Google image search, and like make sure I was liking the right thing. These days it's been very difficult for me to do that, and I honestly, it sucks, because as someone who has done art before, who is an artist herself, who has done commissions before, I know how that feels to have someone who's super supportive and then someone just like kind of go down a bit. But at the same time, I have a life, and if I kept doing like all of that stuff, I would go literally bananas. There are so many people that I love and I appreciate. I appreciate everything that you guys do for me in terms of art. It's just been hard to keep up with that. It's really difficult for me, and I hope you guys can understand that. But I am sorry about that. However, I do not support artists who spread negativity about the MCD community, the community in general, and me. Honestly, it's like, you're allowed to have your own opinion and critique the work that I do. You are absolutely 100% allowed to do that, and you don't even have to like other people in the community. That's perfectly fine. However, just to keep perpetuating that and just pushing that on the community, it's just not healthy for anyone to surround themselves with that kind of negative vibe. It's, I hate to use that phrase, but it's not good. You shouldn't like do that. And anyone who does that is asking for some kind of inner self-destruction. It's just, it's not healthy. And I ask you guys not to treat yourself like that at all. Please don't, because I do care about you all. Even though it's like, sometimes I have to be a, I guess, not a parent, but like a figure of authority sometimes, where I have to say these things. Like right now, I actually have to have a serious conversation, I actually have to sit down and have a serious conversation with you guys, because I want you all to hear the opinions and reasonings behind what I do. So again, I'm not going to support artists or anyone in the community that just spreads constant negativity. You can have your own criticisms of the community and not like certain people in it, perfectly fine. But don't keep perpetuating that until it like explodes. It's not healthy for anyone. That being said, yes, I have unfollowed people over the past couple of days for that exact reason of them spreading negativity in the community and just overall perpetuating it to like the point of constantly devoting everything to it. And that's not healthy in any fandom. It's never healthy. Again, criticism's perfectly fine. Absolutely. But not negativity. Also, heads up, I didn't block them for any reason because, disclosure, I actually have blocked people before. Not because they were spreading, like, you know, criticisms on the things that I actually worked on. Like, that's perfectly fine. You can criticize the stories all you want. You can give your negative opinion on it. But the reason I blocked them was because they started talking about my real life babies. And I'm a mama. And I'm sorry, but I wasn't going to stand for people talking about my babies or bringing them into my YouTube career, because my YouTube career is about me and the people I involve in it. And my vlog, it does include my kids in it, but I'm sorry, that doesn't reflect who I am as a parent, because with my kids, I'm someone completely different. Like, there was this one fan at Michael's that actually saw me in mom mode, and I was like, oh no, this is not good. But seriously, I don't appreciate people talking about my babies, and I blocked them. That was it. Talking about my babies or anything having to do with my parenting? Sorry, I don't deal with that, and that's 100% no, and I did block them. However, I unblocked them recently because all blocking does is just spread more hate and negativity, and at the end of the day, it hurts people, so. Secondly, there are people in the community who believe that I don't listen to or respect views that go against mine. And honestly, I think this has something to do with the relationships and diaries and the way that the story went. Some people wanted the story to go in one direction, and I wanted to go in another.
Oh, this isn't gonna work as well as I thought it was.
Uh-oh, they're messing up. They're feeling the pressure.
Oh dear, nope.
It's 2 seconds!
It's not gonna work.
Time to begin.
Oh no!
Here we come.
I'm sorry, I'm out.
Where could you be? Someone messed up this TV.
I can't say.
Let's see. What about?
My heart is torn in two.
You left me by myself, Kara.
I'm coming.
No, Kara, they left.
Don't.
Kara, run.
Get away.
Have you already found him?
Oh, I guess you could say.
Hey, Zane. You should come hang out with me and Aaron sometime.
Bonsai tree.
Yes, I do remember you speaking about that at one point.
Mm-hmm. I think you two would get along very well.
Really? Aaron doesn't talk much and he doesn't shut up.
Well, you guys don't know Aaron like I do.
That's an understatement.
What?
Nothing.
Mm-hmm. Are you jealous?
Oh, hi, Lawrence.
But jealous? No, of course not. Of course not.
Uh-huh. I can tell in your voice.
Still focusing on trying to hunt.
You're still my BFF. It's okay.
You treated Vlad well when he came around. Good job.
You did. I was so proud of you, Zane. I wasn't expecting you to be like, I'll help you. Brother, because I'm a peep.
Wow, have you been practicing on that imitation this entire time?
I thought it was just you.
My name is Zane, and I'm a little people nugget.
Zane, stop talking about yourself.
you hit that grill, Lawrence. You hit that cheeseburger. Oh, yeah, Lawrence, you hit that cheeseburger.
What is going on over
there?
This
is not helping at all. Wait, what?
Damn it! Come here!
Where did she go?
She's back in the house behind the pool! Darn it! Even if
we... No! No!
That's right, what I found.
I was a tissue box the whole time. Hey.
Yeah, because
probably
you're
because
so full
you
of snot.
Gareth.
Hey, Zane, wipe those tears from your face from your defeat.
Lawrence, this is not going as I had planned it to.
I'm not exactly happy about it either.
Well, we've got to try and make this work somehow.
Oh, I'm dying.
I think I've got another.
Don't die, Afmo.
It'll be fine, Garth. I didn't mean that I was dying literally. Aww.
I can't reach you from here.
Aww. You've been so huggy lately, Garth. Like, what is going on with you?
Well, seeing Vlad just reminded me of how important family and friends are.
Aww.
While we discuss that, let me crush a family member. Come on, Zane.
Wait, what? You just said
Well, crush him in defeat.